home. Daragoy? Oh. Hello, Luca. I'm not sure the middle of the afternoon is the best time to be inside smoking and drinking. Give up. How was your days? Mine is fine, thank you. I just have 1,000 things to do now that I'm home. So absolutely nothing new. I'm sorry, Luca, but none for you. My kisses are reserved. Taragoy? What is this? Well? Why is there a pistol in my kitchen? I think you'll find this a perfectly reasonable question. Why is there a gun in my kitchen? You know how I feel about weapons. I don't want them in my country. Why would I want them in my kitchen? Well? Why are you looking at me like I'm crazy? What's going on? What is that? Luca, will you leave, please? I thought... maybe this wouldn't happen. I knew things were bad, but I felt sure it would never come. That somehow you would be forgotten. Through the cracks. But I was wrong. As I so very usually am. I am so stupid. The other week when you were polishing your boots, My first instinct was, maybe we're going out. Maybe he has something planned. Maybe we will have a nice time. We will forget for an evening what is really happening in our country. But I was wrong, wasn't I? You weren't planning on forgetting. You don't want to forget. You've been waiting for this letter. You've been waiting to be called. You've been wanting the thing that I want the least. What honor is there in dying? What honor is there of being taken away from your family? Being taken to God knows where to die for no cause that we don't even understand? Is that what you want? Truly? Will that fulfill whatever destiny you feel you have? To be blown up? To be mangled and forgotten? That's just what they say. They say they need everyone. They say they need everyone to contribute. Every man, woman, and child. But you are not everyone. You are not just some faceless man to me. You're mine. And to know that you would rather you don't know what you are doing to me. They won't call for me. And I will not go to them. I will not participate in something I do not even believe in. You are asking me to believe in it. You are asking me to put my faith in something I don't even understand. To hope and to wish that we win. Do you even know if we're in the right? Because I don't. I don't understand war. I never have and I never will. Whether that's because I'm too stupid or simple-minded or selfish, I don't know. But I do know this. It is hell. It is the one true hell. And not only is this country asking me to join, to live in hell for however long they decide? But you... you are asking me to act proud. To have faith. To wait and I smile and say, yes, it is hard, but he is doing his bit. He is trying. He might die, but at least I will have the consolation of knowing. I can't even finish the fucking sentence because it's so ridiculous. You won't matter out there. You know that, don't you? You won't matter. You will be one person. And if you fall, you fall. It makes no difference to them. You matter here. You matter to me. You matter to me. That is why I'm asking you. Strong enough. My father used to tell me that. He told me, you have no stomach for war. You should be proud of your country. You should be proud of your father, your brother. And someday you must be proud of your husband. It is not pride I feel. And maybe that makes me weak. Maybe I am not a strong woman. But I am a woman who loves you. A woman who would die for you. Someone who would give anything to see you not do this. My mother was a strong woman. I never saw her cry. I never saw her shake. I never saw her moved. Not even when my father was called. Not even when the man she had had children with was taken away. And when I began to cry, she gripped my shoulder and told me to stop. Stop, she said. You will dishonor your family. You will dishonor your country. I kept crying. I was screaming by the end of it. What country? I asked. What country would ask anyone to do this? She slapped me and said, foolish girl. Weak, foolish girl. I would rather be the weakest, most foolish girl in the world. And pretend I am okay with this. I do not believe in this war. I do not believe in this cause. It's the only thing I believe in. Only man in my life who ever made me feel like I was worth something. Like that weak, foolish girl had every right to cry, had every right to be sad and scared. And I know you will not abandon your country. I know you cannot. And I will not ask you to. You will see. But I will love you. Now, when you leave, and when you come home, I love you. I love you so much, Tara. And you see me there, crying and sad. Please know, it is not weakness. It is not foolishness. It is strength.
What is that? Luca. Will you leave, please? I thought maybe this wouldn't happen. I knew things were bad, but I felt sure it would never come. That somehow you would be forgotten. Slip through the cracks. But I was wrong. As I so very usually am. I am so stupid. See you for a week when you are polishing your boots. My first instinct was maybe we're going out. Maybe he has something planned. Maybe we will have a nice time. We will forget for an evening what is really happening in our country. But I was wrong, wasn't I? You weren't planning on forgetting. You don't want to forget. You've been waiting for this letter. You've been waiting to be called. You've been wanting the thing that I want the least. How could you? What honor is there in dying? What honor is there of being taken away from your family? Being taken to God knows where to die for no cause that we don't even understand? Is that what you want? Truly? Will that fulfill whatever destiny you feel you have? To be blown up? To be mangled and forgotten? That's just what they say. They say they need everyone. They say they need everyone to contribute. Every man, woman, and child. But you are not everyone. You are not just some faceless man to me. You're mine. And to know that you would rather you don't know what you are doing to me. They won't call for me. And I will not go to them. will not participate in something I do not even believe in. But you are asking me to believe in it. You are asking me to put my faith in something I don't even understand. To hope and to wish that we win. Do you even know if we're in the right? Because I don't. I don't understand war. I never have and I never will. Whether that's because I'm too stupid or simple-minded or selfish, I don't know. But I do know this. It is hell. It is the one true hell. And not only is this country asking me to join, to live in hell for however long they decide, but you are asking me to act proud, to have faith, to wait patiently. How can I smile and say, yes, it is hard, but he is doing his bit. He is trying. He might die, but at least I will have the consolation of knowing. I can't even finish the fucking sentence because it's so ridiculous. Won't matter out there. You know that, don't you? You won't matter.
Daragoy? Oh. Hello, Luca. I'm not sure the middle of the afternoon is the best time to be inside smoking and drinking. Give up. How was your days? Mine is fine, thank you. I just have 1,000 things to do now that I'm home. So absolutely nothing new. I'm sorry, Luca, but none for you. My kisses are reserved. Daragoy? What is this? Well? Why is there a pistol in my kitchen? I think you'll find this a perfectly reasonable question. Why is there a gun in my kitchen? You know how I feel about weapons. I don't want them in my country. Why would I want them in my kitchen? Vel? Why are you looking at me like I'm crazy? What's going on? You will be one person. And if you fall, you fall. It makes no difference to them. You matter here. You matter to me. You matter to me. That is why I'm asking you. Strong enough. My father used to tell me that. He told me, you have no stomach for war. You should be proud of your country. You should be proud of your father, your brother. And someday you must be proud of your husband. It is not pride I feel. And maybe that makes me weak. Maybe I am not a strong woman. But I am a woman who loves you. A woman who would die for you. A woman who would give anything to see you not do this. My mother was a strong woman.